We are so honored that you're here to see and be a part of our 2016 State of the County Address. Chairman Dawson is the first female chair of our board in over 30 years. And I find that she's continuing a rich tradition that county government has done since the mid-2000s, when Commissioner Bobby Greer led in our first State of the County Address, followed by Bill Castor, Ted Davis, who's now Representative Davis, Jason Thompson, and myself. It's our opportunity to share with you all the great things that your county government has indeed done. And I find that Chairman Dawson, she is a woman who leads by example. She is a respecter of no person, but a lover of all. Whether you're rich or poor, black or white, Republican, and yes, even Democrat, she makes sure that she represents the entire citizenry of our community. See, I find that leadership at its best is all about relationships, and she's shown how to build those relationships over time throughout our entire community. I'm honored to call her chairman, and I'm proud to call her friend. Please welcome our chair of the county commission, the Honorable Beth Dawson.
Thank you, Vice Chairman Barfield. Good evening. It's great to see so many friends and friendly faces and community servants in the audience this evening. On behalf of your new Hanover County Board of Commissioners, it is my honor to welcome you to this, the 2016 State of the County Address. Our community has many traditions, and sharing this annual address with our citizens, a report on where we stand and where we are going, is a key component of our commitment to be the model of good governance, and I'm honored as your chairman to offer this year's address. It is my privilege to serve with my fellow commissioners and ask that they please stand to be recognized. As you've just heard, Jonathan Barfield, Jr., Vice Chairman. Commissioner Rob Zappel. Commissioner Skip Watkins. And Commissioner and former Chair Woody White. Thank you for your dedicated service to the citizens of New Hanover County. I would also like to recognize and welcome our elected officials who are with us this evening. And let's see, I have two lists, so let me make sure I don't miss anyone. From our North Carolina General Assembly, is there Representative Davis or Representative Hamilton? Okay, not here, all right. Well, we thank them for all they do for New Hanover County. Let me start on this list, sorry. Well, the best sheriff that any state, any county in any state could ever have, and our Sheriff Ed McMahon, thank you all for all you do. From our district court, the Honorable Jay Corpening, our very own Batman. The Honorable Lindsay Luther, thank you for being here. The Honorable Robin Wicks Robinson. And from our municipal partners, from our Wilmington City Council, Mayor Bill Sappho. Mayor Pro Tem Margaret Haynes, Councilman Charlie Rivenbark, Earl. I should just look down and I could see you, right? Councilman Earl Sheridan, Councilman Kevin O'Grady, Councilman Paul Lawler, and Mayor Pro Tem Margaret Haynes. Oh, I got you twice? Okay. And thank you for being here, our city manager, Sterling Cheatham. From our Carolina Beach Town Council, we are pleased to welcome Mayor Dan Wilcox. Councilman Steve Shuttleworth. And Town Manager Michael Kramer. From our Curie Beach Town Council, Mayor Emily Swearingen. And Mayor Pro Tem Craig Belinsky. And Mayor Pro Tem Craig. Thank you. And it's great to see with us tonight someone who does so much for our community, and that is our DA, Ben David. From our partners with the New Hanover County Board of Education, welcome Chairman Don Hayes and Vice Chairman Jeanette Nichols. And our superintendent, Tim Markley, who is working so hard. And also from our Board of Education, Bruce Schell, former county manager. We are pleased to have our federal partners recognized here today, and from Senator Richard Burr's office, our good friend Janet Bradbury is representing Senator Burr. And I do believe I saw from our Board of Education, Lisa Estep. Thank you for being here, Lisa. From our Cape Fear Community College, President Dr. Amanda Lee. And it's always great to see our Chancellor from UNC Wilmington, Dr. Saturelli. I also would like to welcome tonight former county commissioners, both former chairmen, both have been in this spot before, former Commissioner Jason Thompson and former Commissioner Bobby Greer. And it's also nice to welcome Tom Wolf, former commissioner, who is keeping things straight on the ABC board for us. We have several community partners with us that we want to recognize tonight. And very special that he made this trip to Wilmington from Raleigh today, the executive director of our North Carolina Association of County Commissioners, Mr. Kevin Leonard. Here's Kevin. Hey, Kevin. Thank you for being with us, Kevin. From our Wilmington International Airport, Deputy Director Gary Broughton, thank you for being here. As well as authority member, she wears two hats, our airport authority member, Donna Gerardo, and also serves as chairwoman of our planning board. Thank you for being here, Donna. I also see board chairman, Bob Martinez, chairman of our ABC board. Someone very important to spurring the economy here in New Hanover County, and that is the director of our Wilmington Regional Film Commission, who I have enjoyed serving with as chair of that board, Director Johnny Griffin. Hey. From our Wilmington Cape Fear Home Builders Association, Executive Officer Cameron Moore. From Wilmington Downtown Inc., President and CEO Ed Wolverton. Thank you all for all that you do. And our good friend in one of the most effective community programs that we represent, that we appropriate funds to is the director of Kids Making It, Jimmy Pierce. Thanks for being with us. And Jim Fleckner, the executive director of CFPUA. Our partnership with them has gone back many years. Thank you, Jim. And chairwoman of our Cape Fear Public Utility Authority, Pat Cusack, is with us today. Is Pat with us? Hey, Pat, thank you for joining us tonight. And of course, the organization that we just couldn't do without, the Wilmington Chamber of Commerce President and CEO, Connie Majorette. Thank you, Connie. Have I missed anyone? Everyone here is a valued. There she is. Well, you must have come in late, so okay. From our North Carolina General Assembly, welcome Representative Susie Hamilton. Just kidding. We certainly appreciate your partners. It takes all of us working together to get things done for New Hanover County. And I thank you all for your patience. And Kim Hoffman from our Cape Fear Tourism. There she is, Kim. Thanks for keeping us tourism, one of the largest economic engines of our county. We appreciate your keeping us on target there. Most importantly, I would like to recognize and thank the best county staff I think any county has. Sorry, Kevin, you'll have to spread that word across the state. Our county manager, Chris Coudray, thank you for being with us. Our deputy county manager, Avril Pender, and assistant county manager, Tim Burgess, thanks for everything that you do each and every day. Our county attorney, Wanda Copley, and our clerk to the board, Teresa Elmore, thanks for everything. Along with 26 department directors, they represent the 1,700 dedicated professionals who are committed to the efficient delivery of public services and are dedicated to the citizens of New Hanover County. And I believe they're mostly over here in this section. So thank you all for being here and representing the hardworking. And I see Shane Johnston from the Wilmington Regional Association of Realtors. Thank you for being with us. And the new chair of the Wilmington Regional Association of Realtors, Don Harris. Thank you all for all of the advocacy efforts you do on behalf of New Hanover County and making sure the commissioners get information on all the issues that you support. New Hanover County's vision statement is quite clear. A vibrant, prosperous, diverse coastal community committed to building a sustainable future for generations to come. It's quite simple, but it's very clear and very meaningful. With less than 200 square miles, New Hanover County, as you know, is the second smallest of the 100 North Carolina counties. But we include four municipalities, and it is home to more than 216,000 people, with projections to grow by over 120,000 citizens in the next 25 years. We have a diverse population and economy, and we're powered by tourism, film production, manufacturing, retail sectors, and the service industry. We have become the regional leader for commerce with our Port of Wilmington and the Wilmington International Airport, moving people and goods globally every day. While this projected growth in population represents enormous opportunities, it also presents great responsibilities and challenges. How we define our generation of leadership will define our community for future generations. I am confident, however, that we are up to that challenge, but it will take all of us working together in new and better ways to accomplish our goals. We are fortunate to live in an area with an exceptionally high quality of life, supported by an excellent healthcare system, university, and community college. Decisions we make today will impact our future in many areas, including transportation, infrastructure, land use, schools, public services, housing, and our natural resources. It is our responsibility as your elected representatives to be good stewards of our citizens' assets, to preserve the quality of life that we love, to provide the foundation for economic growth, to provide a good education system, and to keep our citizens safe and healthy through the adoption of policies in order to make fiscally responsible, prudent decisions on behalf of all of the citizens of New Hanover County. Under the category of fiscal responsibility, I'm pleased to report that all economic indicators point to a growing economy, and the state of New Hanover County is fiscally strong. In 2015, New Hanover County once again received a AAA bond rating, the highest a county can achieve from both Moody's Investor Service and Standard & Poor's Rating Services. The county's sound budgeting and financial management combined with our thriving local economy are key to obtaining the best ratings for our debt. New Hanover County is one of only seven counties in North Carolina. Take note, Mr. Leonard, and approximately 80 of the nation's 3,069 counties to achieve this rating. As a double AAA rated county, New Hanover County is rated in the top 3% of all counties in our country. With the adoption of our debt and fund balance policies, which set financial priorities from your commissioners 2 years ago under the chairmanship of Commissioner Woody White, along with our highly capable staff offering sound policy options to our board, we will be able to obtain the very best rates and terms for our bond debt in order to build our schools, our community college buildings, and complete our parks projects. All of these bond referendums, the park bond issue and the New Hanover County school bond issue, all passed, and the community college bond issue, all passed with overwhelming support by the citizens of New Hanover County, over 60%, which sent a message loud and clear to your elected representatives that our citizens support education and quality of life initiatives that will make New Hanover County the best community in which to work, live, play, raise families, educate children, and further their education for job training and career opportunities. County taxpayers have every reason to have confidence in the efficiency and effectiveness of its county government. Many thanks to our Chief Financial Officer, Lisa Wurzbacher, and her team for all they do for the citizens of New Hanover County. Thank you, Lisa. Under the category of strategic plan and progress, in order to chart a course for the future, in order to recognize our opportunities and overcome our challenges, New Hanover County adopted a strategic plan in 2012 to guide direction for growth and ensure our success. This plan is updated and is reaffirmed by your commissioners annually. The New Hanover County Enterprise Strategy Map sets forth our policy priorities and focuses on three strategic priorities: promoting intelligent growth and economic development, supporting superior education in the workforce, and providing superior public health and public safety. This strategic plan defines how your resources will be used and measures the effectiveness of our success. And thanks to the leadership of Beth Schrader, our budget director, she makes sure that before anything comes to the budget table, that it must meet one of these priorities. Thank you, Beth. Your Board of County Commissioners has established an economic development as its first priority, and consecutive community surveys clearly identified the single highest priority of taxpayers is more jobs and better jobs. I am pleased to report that 3 years into our five-year strategic plan, we have made substantial progress toward our goals aimed at these three key initiatives. Promoting intelligent growth and economic development, our goal was to stimulate private sector investment of at least $1 billion in property value in order to grow our tax base. Our three-year progress is $966 million. A goal to support the creation of 6,000 new high-quality jobs created in targeted industry sectors. Our three-year progress, over 8,000, exceeding our goal. 10% increase in the local average weekly wage. Our three-year progress is below anticipated at 4.4%, so we will continue to recruit and retain business and expand job opportunities. Our goal to reduce juvenile recidivism by 5%. Our three-year progress is that it was decreased to 7%. Thank you to our Sheriff Ed McMahon and all of the public safety initiatives that we partner with you. Our goal of having 80% of children entering kindergarten that are ready to learn, and those numbers are not quite in, but we are following those and helping to support programs will ensure the success of that program. Economic development is a phrase that we hear often, but what does it mean to our community? It means attracting new manufacturing businesses like Vertex Rail and growing and retaining jobs at existing companies like AAI Pharma, PPD, Corning Incorporated, GE Aviation, Castle Branch, Fortron, Live Oak Bank, to name a few. It means growing our knowledge industry, supporting tourism, and incubating new startups. Good, high-paying jobs are a necessity for our community, and our goal is to enable, as I said before, $1 billion in private investment. Our local economy has also created 8,000 new jobs, more than our goal, and while we're not quite there yet, we continue to pursue our goal of increasing the average weekly wage. In addition to our strategic plan, we are also making progress on the priorities identified in the Gardner Report's Pathways to Prosperity, including regional economic development marketing initiatives, working regionally with our surrounding counties, because we know what is good for New Hanover is good for Brunswick, is good for Pender, and vice versa. So many of our citizens work here but live there, or work there and live here. So we must maintain a regional approach to economic development. Our regional economic development marketing initiatives and partnering with our City of Wilmington and Cape Fear Public Utility Authority to run water and sewer along the 421 corridor was one of the priorities from the Pathways to Prosperity. The Highway 421 water and sewer expansion is included in our fiscal year 16-20 recommended capital improvement plan adopted by your Board of County Commissioners this past June. It has been a priority of the Commissioner's strategic plan for several years to promote a strong, diverse economy and quality job growth. We are pleased to see businesses locate and expand up the Highway 421 corridor and know that this capital investment in infrastructure will encourage economic development and job creation for many years to come. And that initiative, I want to just give a shout out to former Commissioner Tom Wolf. He really took the lead on making sure we got started on that particular project. Through strategic partnerships with the City of Wilmington and working with our regional economic development partners and key community stakeholders, we will continue to work with our community's advocacy organizations to listen to all sides of every issue important to our citizens and our businesses, and we will work hard to make informed decisions to ensure New Hanover County continues to grow and to prosper, and with the quality of life we all enjoy. We want to thank the folks for all of their efforts and our regional marketing efforts, North Carolina Southeast, Wilmington Business Development, Wilmington Downtown Inc., and the Wilmington Chamber of Commerce. Thank you for everything that you do to ensure our regional success. New Hanover County has thoroughly evaluated the return on investment and appropriated funding for economic development grants for the retention and the recruitment of business and new job creation. Jobs with good salaries that will result in $218 million in private sector investment for capital improvements and expanding our tax base. These same investments will have a return of the potential of over 1,500 jobs with an average salary of nearly $70,000. We have also invested in our municipal partners, including an economic investment grant to the town of Carolina Beach, which rebuilt its aging boardwalk so that it is now accessible to all of our citizens and our visitors. And signs of economic revitalization in the business district of Carolina Beach are showing great progress. This opened in the spring of 2015, and if you haven't visited, I suggest that you do so. Thank you to Councilman Shuttleworth and Mayor Wilcox for your leadership in this effort. Excuse me. I would like to add here at this point that I would like to thank our businesses. We have been successful in recruiting and retaining and growing jobs, but we have a long way to go, and we will continue to make good appropriations if it looks like it's going to have a good return on investment. I would like to thank our businesses for choosing New Hanover County for their business and for employing thousands of our citizens who have also chosen to live and raise their families here. Many of you have invested in our community for decades, and not only are you providing good jobs and producing goods for the global markets, but you also have embraced our community and have supported our area's nonprofit organizations with your employees' time and your philanthropic contributions, and for that, we thank you. Just a few examples. Corning Incorporated. Did I see, hey, Michelle Holbrook, General Manager. Thank you for being with us this evening, Michelle. A few examples. Corning Incorporated supports educational programs for STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math at our Cape Fear Museum of History and Science to support education programs for children and young folks. And GE Hitachi has recently awarded our Cape Fear Museum a grant for STEM education programs for a family learning center as well. Verizon is a consistent supporter of the domestic violence shelter and services, while Castle Branch offers their employees the opportunity to volunteer with the Wilmington Area Rebuilding Ministry. And Duke Energy recently contributed to the Wilmington Children's Museum to support STEM education programs. So thank you for choosing New Hanover County, and thank you for embracing our community. Economic development and job retention also means restoring and rebuilding our film industry. And I want to thank our legislators, Senator Michael Lee, Representative Ted Davis, and Representative Susie Hamilton for their leadership in bringing film jobs back to New Hanover County. Despite the uncertainty of the future of our state program, local production spending in 2015 was $85 million. The action of the North Carolina legislature did not go unnoticed by the film industry. In fact, we have the same number of new project inquiries in the last 4 months in 2015 as we did in the preceding 8 months of uncertainty. Two production offices for television series have opened offices so far in 2016, and the combined local spending is estimated to be $55 million. New Hanover County is open for business, and we welcome the film industry. I want to thank Johnny Griffin, our director of the Wilmington Regional Film Commission, and my fellow board members, including Mayor Bill Sappho, for your leadership and legislative advocacy efforts. I also would like to thank our local legislators, especially Representative Davis and Representative Hamilton, for continuing the historic preservation tax credits, another key driver of success in our local economy. Through the creation of job opportunities, business opportunities, and therefore increasing the property tax base for these historic properties. And recognize George Edwards and the Historic Wilmington Foundation for your advocacy efforts and all you do to protect our historic properties. Addressing growth and our New Hanover County comprehensive plan, planning for the future. New Hanover County is well on our way in this long-range planning process with our New Hanover County comprehensive plan. A multi-year process, goals set by many stakeholders through citizen participation in public community meetings, and with contributions from your county commissioners, will guide policies for informed future land use decisions in order to accomplish our goals of growth and accomplish our growth priorities and our challenges. Increased density, multi-uses, and development patterns for our limited remaining land will all be considered. We will continue to be involved in this process as this land use plan is utilized to update the New Hanover County zoning ordinances and encourage responsible growth with effective, efficient, and predictable regulatory processes and procedures to encourage business growth while being a good steward of our unique coastal environment, natural resources, and quality of life. Education is one of the primary responsibilities of county government, as well as a key element in economic development and in the attraction of new companies to our region. We are committed to providing for superior education and facilities and providing for the services that are not only mandated by the state, but also, now you look up, that are not only mandated by the state, but also providing for the services that our citizens need in order to have growing, prosperous communities with the quality of life we all enjoy. Superior education is one of New Hanover County's strategic priorities. As well, it is 40% of our general operating fund budget. While we are proud that our local workforce already exceeds the national average in the percentage of high school and college graduates, we cannot afford to lose ground. To ensure that that doesn't happen, we are partnering with the New Hanover County Schools to supplement teacher salaries and to fund over 600 additional positions in the schools. We work with our Board of Education members to prioritize capital projects. Safe and secure learning environments are crucial to our student success. It is time to bring technology into the classrooms, move classrooms out of the hallways, and give our teachers the tools they need in their classroom for success. And thank you. Thank you we have a great working relationship with our Board of Education members, and we thank you for that continued cooperation. In November, we broke ground for the new Porter's Neck School, which will help us manage the tremendous growth in that area. As we look at meeting our wider educational needs, we celebrate the strong community support for the 2015 school bond referendum, and we are now implementing the programs and projects that were approved. In addition to the projects for the new Hanover County Public Schools, we began construction of the new Advanced and Emerging Technologies facility at Cape Fear Community College's North Campus and the renovation to existing buildings on the downtown campus. This $40 million investment was paid for by the voter-approved 2008 Cape Fear Community College bonds. Our community college is an integral part of our community, providing educational opportunities for all citizens, attracting business and entrepreneurs to New Hanover County. We must and will continue to support its mission. I am pleased to announce that after many years of conversations, consensus is finally being built among your elected officials and the Cape Fear Community College for an alternative vocational pathway for our students. This shows great prospects for job training, a skilled workforce for our businesses, and the reduction in the dropout rate if the students have the pathway to success in an alternative vocational high school. The New Hanover County School System and the Cape Fear Community College have been working on a career technical education high school. Participants include elected officials from the Board of Education, from New Hanover County, the City of Wilmington, our Community College Board of Trustees, and our state legislature. The idea is to provide our students with a technical alternative to college when a four-year college is not the path they want to take. But then if they go through this program and decide to then pursue a four-year college education, we will send them your way, Dr. Saturelli, where students will earn credentials, learn a trade, and end up with a lot of job opportunities. This economic development opportunity speaks to jobs, unemployment, crime reduction, and just plain old common sense of helping our youth succeed. The Board of Education will be presenting this concept to the New Hanover County Board of Commissioners at our next meeting, February the 15th. This is an exciting opportunity that is long overdue. As we discuss our workforce and education, I want to be sure to mention that we are working to help our veterans, the veterans of our nation's armed forces, find jobs and get a good education. We are blessed with many neighbors that have served our country, and New Hanover County Veterans Services Office and Director, Mr. Ellis Pender, assists veterans and eligible family members apply for benefits through the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs and other agencies. If you have served and are able, if you're a veteran and would like to stand, we would like to thank you for your service. Thank you. That is just one of the many important departments of your New Hanover County government. I was honored to attend the Vietnam Veterans of America celebration weekend, and especially the celebration at Hugh McCrae Park for a rededication of our Veterans Memorial and to rename a road in the park as Freedom Way in honor of the 50th anniversary of the end of the Vietnam War. New Hanover County Parks and Gardens Department, under the leadership of Tara Duckworth, did a terrific job of renovating that area around the memorial. And if you haven't been there, please take a visit to Hugh McCrae Park and take a look at this renovated landscape. It's terrific. Thank you, Tara, and your team. I'd like to stop here just a moment because I would like to recognize a very important member of our community who does so much for the citizens of New Hanover County. I see our District Court Judge, the Honorable James Faison, has joined us. Thank you. Addressing public safety. Public safety must remain the top priority. We must encourage community conversations and support our Sheriff's Department with policies and initiatives to end this violence among our community's youth and gang-related tragedies. The county commissioners have taken steps to focus on gang interventions, with our sheriff working with the City of Wilmington Police Chief, Mr. Chief Evangelist. We have increased support for our school-based mental health staff and at-risk youth programs, and we have supported increased support for evidence-based programs and youth empowerment services, and want to thank Kathy Stoot and her team and Community Justice Services for all that they do. As we have increased funding for these, and we have increased funding for the sheriff's efforts on gang intervention programs and working with joint task forces with the City of Wilmington Police. Thank you, Mayor, and the City Council members for that collaborative effort. In 2015, our law enforcement leaders, Judge Corpening, our District Attorney Ben David, our public defender Jennifer Harjo, the school superintendent, the county, and the city all signed an interagency governance agreement on the handling of school offenses. The premise of the agreement is that schools and law enforcement share responsibility for school safety and must work together with complementary policies and procedures with the goal of a safe learning environment for everyone. The safety and security of our community, encouraging efforts to reduce and prevent crime, will influence our ability to provide the best education system and learning environments, as well as impact our success in the recruitment and retention of business and job creation, and impact our quality of life and our economy. I am pleased to report that the policies already in place have reduced juvenile recidivism by 7% compared to our five-year target of 5. We may have met that goal, but we still have much to do. And in fact, I'm meeting with the mayor and jointly with city and county later this week to talk about continuing those community conversations and what we can all partner to do in this area. It's just tragic. Also, in our priority of public safety, I want to be sure to highlight the efforts of New Hanover County's Fire Rescue and the leadership of Chief Donnie Hall. Is Donnie here? In 2015, we enhanced our ability to serve the community by purchasing land to build our new fire station in Ogden, addressing the growth in a fast-growing area of our county. We were so very impressed with the services provided by our fire service, including educating citizens on smoke detectors, proper use of car seats for children, and even going door to door informing residents of the status of the closed road, Edgewater Club Road, during the October storms. These are truly remarkable men and women, and please join me in thanking them for all that they do. I am also pleased to report that we were able to do all of this and that we were able to reduce the fire service district tax in the unincorporated areas of the county by nearly 1 cent off of your tax rate without compromising on our public safety goal or the financial integrity of the fire service district fund. Thank you to our manager, Coudray, for recommending that reduction. And also here, talking about emergencies and emergency management, I would like to thank the director of our emergency management 911, Warren Lee, for everything he does for this community. I tell you, if we have a storm or a rain or any kind of catastrophe, Warren is on top of it, and we want to thank him for everything he does to keep us safe and healthy. Moving forward, in the category of quality of life initiatives, New Hanover County leads the nation in what we call keeping sand on the beach. Our beaches have literally led the nation on how to manage and sustain our coastline. It's no surprise that New Hanover County, surrounded by water and committed to a sustainable environment, focuses a lot of attention on maintaining our natural resources. And it's not just about our quality of life, it's about our tourism and economic development. Shoreline protection, under the leadership of Leighton Bedsole, also called the Sandman. Okay. Thank you, Leighton, for all that you do. Working with our beach towns, trying to come up with mutual agreements so that we can continue that great quality of life and the impact it has to tourism. And Kim Huffam can tell us that's real important. Shoreline protection is a critically important issue to New Hanover County and to our beach communities. Also for our tourism industry, as I said, which is a major factor, which one of the major economic engines in our economy. We will continue to work with our partners in the federal government, as well as those in Raleigh. Listen up, Janet Bradbury, to take to Senator Burr and our representatives in Raleigh to ensure that we have a dedicated, sustainable source of funding for our beach and our inlets. And your county commissioners will be working with our local delegation to find that sustainable source of funding for our beaches and our inlets. And I see Chance Lambeth from Congressman David Rouser's office back there. Chance, I'm sorry I missed introducing you earlier. Thank you for everything you do and Congressman Rouser does to stay in touch with New Hanover County. He's working real hard for us as well. I want to be sure to highlight some of the other treasures we have here in New Hanover County, in addition to our beaches. Don't want our beach town mayors questioning that. We certainly don't. But we have some terrific and very valuable citizen assets that we're charged to take care of. Our Airlie Gardens, our Kayfair Museum of History and Science, and the Arboretum are all county properties. And they are our gems and our libraries. And thank you to Harry Tuckmeyer for all that he does. We are building a new library, renovating a library, and increasing programs for children and educational programs. Our citizens' assets, our parks, gardens, our libraries, our museum, are our gems, and it is our responsibility to treasure and to commit to sustaining those treasures that mean so much to the citizens of New Hanover County. You know, when county governments were formed back in the 1800s, the primary responsibilities we were given were for education, public health, taking care of the courts, taking care of the poor, and that's about all of the responsibility and authority we had from the state of North Carolina as an arm of the state. It is through careful policy decisions of the leaders that have come before us who have made decisions to invest in the assets our citizens have said they want and they need for their quality of life, and that helps attract business to our area as well. We have invested in our New Hanover County parks to enhance our great quality of life, and we will be looking forward to improving our Northern Regional Park in Castle Hayne, as the northern part of the county is one of the fastest growing, and the desire for outdoor recreation is important to our citizens. We will continue to support and protect these citizen assets that contribute so much to our quality of place. I want to mention here a recent initiative that the Board of County Commissioners unanimously approved at our last meeting, and it regards how we are handling mental health issues here in New Hanover County. Substance abuse, developmental disabilities are all concerns statewide as challenges are trying to be met as the state changes the way that we will be able to continue to handle that. And here in New Hanover County, we have made a commitment and welcome the partnership with Healing Transitions and Trillium Health Resources to provide a recovery facility in our community. It will make a tremendous impact in our region by offering recovery services to those who need it most. We will see a positive return on this county's investment in a short period of time and delay anticipated expansion costs for our jail as we reduce jail capacity. This program would be utilized as a jail diversion program under the leadership of many of our district court judges, our DA. We have worked hard to initiate this program, and it will delay folks going to the emergency room and impacting the cost of that the hospital bears, the New Hanover County Regional Hospital bears, so we can direct these folks to the recovery services that they need. This unanimous decision by your Board of Commissioners is evidence of our commitment to our community to provide the services to our citizens in the most effective manner, as well as improve the quality of life for those citizens that need it most. So as we look forward to 2016, your county commissioners will continue along the path of updating our planning policies. We will demonstrate that New Hanover County is a great place to live, work, vacation, and to retire. We will maintain our AAA rating from the rating agencies and remain prudent with your tax dollars. And we will also always evaluate the return on investment and make sure you receive the best value for your tax dollars. And at this time, I would like to refresh our memory that we discussed this last year and perhaps ask our county staff to look into this before our budget comes further, and that is to reevaluate our projected revenues and perhaps reevaluate our fund balance percentages. What is required? We do want to be prepared for any kind of emergency or economic opportunity, but we want to make sure we are utilizing the citizens' tax dollars most prudently. So we will try to, with the consensus of my board, have that conversation as we get a little bit closer to our budget discussions. So in closing, my vision for New Hanover County moving forward is cooperation, collaboration, and communication. We cannot do it alone. We need all of these community partners in this room working together. We need to continue to work together with our business leaders, our educators, our medical community, our judicial community, members of our arts and cultural community, community volunteers, our pastors, our faith-based community organizations, and particularly public officials from our municipalities, to our state legislators, to our federal partners, and that is the only way that we will continue to ensure that New Hanover County grows and prospers. As together, we are stewards of our future, and the decisions that we all make together collectively will shape what I know will be the brightest possible future for New Hanover County. Thank you all for being here tonight, for your commitment to our community, and for all of the work you do on behalf of our community. I also would like to thank the many citizen volunteers that serve on our over 30 boards and commissions in our community, working and partnering with us to make good decisions as we look to their leadership. And thank you all if you serve on a board or commission here in New Hanover County. We are hats off to you, because that's a lot of work, I know. For myself, it's an honor and a privilege to serve and to work with each and every one of you all. and I'm pleased to report the state of our county is strong and we will continue to grow and prosper and enjoy New Hanover County and the quality of life in this community that we all love to call home. Thank you.